All right, so you think you need to feel desire for intimacy for things to be okay in your relationship. You know, that you're supposed to spontaneously want this. It should be on your mind. This is something you should easily want. And if that's not your experience, something must be wrong. And I get it. I know why you think that. I hear this from all the time from people, that they're struggling to feel that desire. Maybe they think they could go their whole life without it and be just fine. And then they're thinking something is really wrong with that. Because we're not shown this anywhere. Nobody is talking about difficulty with desire or struggling to access that. TV, movies, everybody's having it, you know, an easy time without any work. That's the only thing that's portrayed in the media. And our friends and family and neighbors and coworkers aren't talking about this, right? So we think we're alone. So it's common to not really feel desire inside, you know, naturally, spontaneously, but it doesn't mean we don't have desire inside. So it's sort of like going to the gym. We don't usually wake up in the morning, can't wait to go exercise. I mean, some people do, but plenty of us don't. But that doesn't mean that once we go work out, we're not glad we were there. We have a great, you know, a great experience. It's like, oh, this really matters to me. I want to do this again next time. Right? There's a desire that can be inside that we can access. And desire for intimacy is the same way. Now, if we struggle with motivation for the gym, we get help. Right? We hire a trainer, we get a workout buddy, or at least we understand it's normal. But what do we do about intimacy? When we struggle with that motivation, or it's not right, like right there at our fingertips, we feel bad about ourselves. We think we're broken. We think we're missing some essential human drive that everybody else has. And then we're not likely to get any help, or we're not willing to sort of look at it and rethink the situation. We're going to feel shame. We're going to feel isolated and alone, right? That's what happens. And maybe you've been there. Maybe that's exactly where you've been, or maybe that's where your partner has been. You know, not feeling the spontaneous desire, and you both are thinking something is really fundamentally wrong. So if you continue to think that your desire should just show up spontaneously, easily, all the time, you're going to stay stuck because you're going to think you're just broken. It's going to prevent you from looking at it, from taking action, from getting help, or just doing the things you need to do to access desire, because you can cultivate it. Okay, there are basically two ways of experiencing desire for intimacy. So one is what I call proactive. That's that spontaneous interest. That's what we see portrayed in TVs and movies. Okay, this is on my mind. I'm getting spontaneously interested, maybe even aroused. I would like to make this happen. That is proactive desire. Okay, some people have that. Some people have it some of the time. Okay, that's one way. But there's also what I call reactive desire. That's where it's not on your mind. You're not thinking about it. Maybe it's the last thing you think about. I'd rather get sleep, right? It's just not there for you right on the surface. But if you get going, if things are right between you and your partner, you get what you need. You get the pace you need, you get the touch you need, you get the time you need. Oh, your body starts to respond. I'm starting to get interested. Now I'm interested in intimacy. The desire shows up partway through. It shows up after you start. That's reactive desire. So if you don't feel the proactive kind, the spontaneous kind, it's totally normal. You just have to accommodate this other reality. Nothing is broken. We all tend to have reactive desire some of the time. The longer you're in a relationship, the older you get, there are stresses in life or other burdens or other responsibilities, this is where our desire goes. Nothing is broken. So how do you access that kind of desire? Well, first you need the opportunity. It has to have an opportunity to emerge. You've got to start. Okay, so sometimes that's going to mean addressing some relationship problems or issues with your partner. You got to feel good enough about each other. You got to take the pressure off, but you've got to start. Okay, it needs that opportunity. Without commitment, you're not promising that that desire is going to show up. You actually have no idea yet, but you've got to start. Then you need input. You've got to know something about what it is you need. Or if you don't know, you need to explore that and figure it out so that you can have some input into what happens so that you're increasing the likelihood that you could access desire. So still not a guarantee. It's not like if you follow the recipe, it's always going to show up. It doesn't work like that. But you can have agency and input into what's happening so that your desire has more opportunity to show up. And then lastly, you need what I call flexibility. It's the big maybe, okay? You're not guaranteeing that you're gonna end up interested. You're not guaranteeing that you're gonna have intimacy the way that maybe you think you should or that your partner is gonna want. Somewhere between 5% of the time and 95% of the time, your desire will show up, but it won't be 100%. So that's gotta be okay. You've gotta be able to go into this experience with a maybe. Both you and your partner understanding that it's a maybe. And you learn to enjoy what you're doing while you're doing it just for what it is, without being goal-oriented, without committing, without pressure that you have to end up interested. You've got to have that kind of flexibility together to make this a space that you can go into easily. So this is how you approach intimacy. If one or both of you struggles to access that desire, if you feel like you've got no libido, you need to learn to access it, to bring it forward, because it's just reactive. It's in there, right? That's what we have to do. If you don't do that, if you continue to think that your desire is supposed to just show up naturally and spontaneously, you're going to keep thinking you're broken. You're gonna keep thinking something is really wrong. You might start thinking I'm with the wrong person or our relationship is doomed. That's gonna keep you stuck. That's gonna keep you from creating those opportunities to engage, from having the input you could have, and embracing the flexibility that you need. Maybe that's exactly where you've been, feeling disheartened and discouraged and broken and inadequate, but you don't have to. If you're curious about this, if you want to learn how to access desire, it's part of my Intimacy with Ease program, and I've got a free training video that goes into what it takes to create this easy intimacy in your relationship, and I would love for you to join me there.